Okay, this is a bud of the flower. So this is supposed to be open tomorrow. So at afternoon time, so the flower bud supposed to be bloomed or flower at the morning, tomorrow morning. So one day before, that means today afternoon about 4:30 to 5, you have to bag it. And after that, after bagging, because if the flower is already open, so that means it will occur the undesired polybased pollination from somehow. So we have to protect that also. For this protection, so you have to bag, because our target is to maintain the parental line seed purity. So that means we have to pollinate from the same flower, the pollen from the same flower. So you should not give any chances the pollen coming from other plants or any other sources, because all time there are the insects, bees, or so many other flies are everywhere. Even the ants also help in pollination. So for the protection, we have to ensure that we have to bag the unopened flower one day before, that means about the afternoon time. Then next morning we will do the self pollination again. Okay, so now I am showing you how to bag the flowers on the before afternoon. So at afternoon time, I already mentioned that the flower supposed to be open tomorrow morning. So when you see the flower, you can easily realize that this flower will open tomorrow. So before that, we have to bag. So this is the bag. So this is the transparent bag, or sometimes it's called also waterproof, or sometimes we can also use the paper bag also can. So this is the bag. So you have to do this is, so like this, you have to pour inside the bag the bud. Okay, so after fully, so that means you have to ensure that the no insect can go inside. So you have the butterfly cleaf, or also called the jack cleaf, for the tying. So others, you can give a fold here. Okay, like this. Then you just use the cleaf to make it tight. Thus we should not give any chances for the entering any bees, any ants, or any other insects. So this is called the bagging. So this is completely bagging. So tomorrow morning about 9 to 10 in the morning, so the flower will open. So when the flower will open, we will open the bag. Then after that, I will show how we can do the pollination, self pollination again. So after bagging, how it looks like. So you see, this is the jack leaf we have used to tie properly, and there is no space that bee or insect can go inside. So this is the bagging. One day before, at afternoon time, we have to bag by this way. Then you have to keep and you have to wait until next morning about 9 to 10, if the weather is okay. But if the rainy, then they use little bit delay for flowering. Okay, you can see yesterday we bagged the unbloomed flower. So you can see inside the bag the flower is already bloomed. So now we have to open and we have to do the pollination. This is called control cell pollination. So they have so many pollen inside with the anther, so we can just do the pollination by hand. So I am now showing how to open, how to pollinate, and how to re-bag again. Now I am trying to show how to reopen. So we use the jack cleaf. So you have to open the cleaf first, like this. Okay, then you have to slowly open. You can see the flower is already open. So everything can see here. So stigma, anther, everything. So for the artificial pollination, we like to. This is all the anther. So you can see huge pollen, the yellow color. Huge pollen. So you collect the pollen and just toss on the stigma. So this is the pollination. Okay, so pollination done. So after pollination, you have to use the tag, because you have to maintain the fruit until harvesting. So this is the same plant. So I use this male and female. So the same. So might be P1. Just one etiquette. One identification to identify the fruits you have already self-pollinated. So like this, you have to tie the
tag for the future identification. Otherwise, there are so many fruits. So from one plant, maybe you are using only one for the control, or maybe several if you want to use several. So you have to use several tag. So you hang the tag here like this. Then you have to rebag. So during that time, if you are rebagging, so due to the rain, the bag is already wet. So for the rebagging, you can remove the petals, or if you want to keep, so like you can do like this, and you have to rebag because the whole day. So or you can remove the petal for the to make it easier. So you just remove the petal and rebag again, because this is fully controlled. So if you keep open, then maybe insect, bees or other flies, they will come and they will do the undesired pollination again. So because still we don't know it is successful. So when it is successful, after 2 to 3 days, you can open, you can see the new fruits like this, the baby fruit. So then you can open, but you have to maintain the tag until harvesting the fruit. So this is the controlled self pollination.